Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hey everybody, on this occasion, we will present about the control of resistant plants and biological control. Before introduction, we are from Dukban, which consists of... Hanifah Salsabila, NIM 114, Delvina Judith Alivia, NIM 002, Dia Ajeng Lestari, NIM 007, Adviro Amrina Stangin, NIM 011, Ichi Siombing, NIM 023, Dewi Zunita, NIM 030, and Angelita Asamadeni, NIM 031. To shorten the time, I invite Hanifah Salsabila to start the presentation.
Plant resistance. Resistance and vulnerability are relative terms with no sharp boundaries. Suppose you plant cultivar is resistant to specific pathogen attack. Well, all cultivars are said to be susceptible. In that case, that means that the first cultivar has a higher resistance than the second cultivar. This resistance and susceptibility may vary due to environmental influence and pathogen risk. Next. Next is resistant host plant to pathogenic infection, specific or vertical resistant. This resistance is controlled by a single gene or multiple genes of the cultivar responsible for resistance. Often, this is effective only for certain pathogenic risk and does not confer resistance against other risk. This step of resistant is called specific resistant or vertical resistant. Vertical resistant characteristic is the first is vertical resistant mechanism are usually inherited as a single gene or as multiple genes. B, vertical resistant usually provide a high degree resistant but is quickly lost when virulent pathogen threat are present. C, a vertical resistance is said to be a hypersensitive reaction in the host. The vertical resistance often result in the slow onset of epidemic. Next.
Resistance of host plant to pathogenic infection. Horizontal resistance or like number of pathogens. Although it is not 100% effective. Horizontal resistance is further in the net. The will not promote the selective increases of contained resistance of the pathogen, as is the case with vertical resistance. In much circumstances, the pathogenic population will be staged and the number is decreased. Its cost will be reduced or decreased as well. Horizontal resistance character usually profit along the level that is real profit take immune or the resistance usually increased in a polygenic manner in profit. Horizontal resistance mechanism operates before the after the pathogenic has occupied of the host. Next. How to get the resistant variety? This is the farmer must go through several stakes which are as follow. One, identifikasi sources of the disease resistance. Two, determination of the mechanism. Three, causing resistant trend with their economic trend can be the very given or for genetic analysis and resistant trait. Five, identification of biological and biotherminical properties of the plant resistance. Six, conducting multi-location testing. Seven, tillage of new resistant plant varieties. Next.
Advantage and disadvantage of management with resistant plants. Advantage of management with resistant plants, number one is specific effect, only effect on the target pest or disease and do not affect natural enemies. Number two, the cumulative effect, that is the effect from season to season, will reduce the pest population. Number three is, that is harmless and requires a relatively low cost. Number four is easy to apply. Disadvantage of management with resistant plants. Number one is limited genetic resource. Number two, it takes a long time to get resistant varieties. Number three, the existence of resistance to pests of a plant is often not in line with the resistant nature. Plant resilience requirement. Resistance must be maintained by plants in various growing conditions and various level of attack. Resilience must be stable genetically. If the pathogen has several rest, the cultivar should resist the rest that might attack it. It is recommended that one superior variety has sufficient resistance to several diseases that may arise. For example, peanut varieties Anoa, deer, and rabbit are resistant to leaf spot. Cercosporidium personatum and Cercospora arachidicola, leaf rust or Puccinia arachidis, and bacterial wilt Pseudomonas solanacearum.
Therein, 1965 definition in Guarani for words which takes the biological control into and to reduce the intensive of plant diseases by using the help for one or more living organisms other than the host plant in itself and humans. Antagonism, the principle of biological control has been since 1917, against fungus, rigidosaurus, microbus, ombrugus, saprophyll, fungi are profit with a good entrainment for growth to mold the remain of the root that come the face to prevent of poisoning or tree poisoning and by plant reduce cover. Pay for cover or LCC.
Plant growth promoting rhizobacteria. It is also known that the presence of microorganisms in the rhizosphere can be used for biological control. Resistance boost. Resistance to disease can be obtained by means of inducing resistance, namely treatment before pathogen, infection with chemical compounds, or by inoculation of non-pathogenic microorganisms. Cross-protection. In viral disease, biological control is carried out by cross-protection or pre-immunization Plants inoculated with a weak virus strain suffer little damage, but will protect from infection with a strong strain.
Next, mixed plants. In Japan, it is known that water gourd, Legionaria, Ciceraria, grown together with leek is less susceptible to Fusarium wilt disease, Fusarium oxysporum F, SP, Legionaria. It is suspected that this is due to the development of Pseudomonas gladioli bacteria on the roots of leeks. Shallots have also been tried to control Fusarium wilt disease in tomatoes and strawberries. Homa, 1900. Next. Post-harvest disease control. Treatment of fruit with certain organisms has been shown to reduce deposit disease in fruit. Certain isolate to Pseudomonas syringae, PV, recrements can control Penicillium expansum, Acrimonium brave can control Botrytis cinerea, and Bacillus subtilis control Monilia fractigena. For this treatment, the bacteria can be excited with certain fungicides, for example, B. subtilis mixed with dichloran to control Rhizopus root. The result of these studies have not been used in practice. Jenny C. Witch, 1990. And the last, in there is strength and weakness. Strength, the first A, high control success rate with low cost over a long period of time. B, active biological control agent reach their host or prey, grow and develop following the dynamics of the host or prey population. C, biological control has no negative effect on human and the environment. The weakness, initial research to find solution to problem with biological control requires a large number of technical staff and expert, is expensive and take a long time. Back to moderator.
Okay, thank you. Enough of this presentation from our group. If there are questions, we can discuss them via Spada. Hope it's useful. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.